Phuket International Airport takes its safety very seriously, with airport security, the national police, and the tourist police all guarding the terminals. Visitors and staff are in safe hands. Supporting the full-time staff are a squad of volunteers who aid the tourist police, like Ian, who has been volunteering for 6 years with his wife, Cathy, who's been by his side every step of the way, that is, when she's not on a Segway.
It's a new day at the airport, so we're starting our morning shift again. With our usual routine, we're now going to do our morning patrol. Patrols will take about 25 minutes.
The airport is so security-minded that even security go through security.
So far, so good. But usually this section, most people are just trying to get their luggage and trying to get out of the airport. So now we are heading up to the International Departures Lounge. We're just checking for anything out of the ordinary. Travelers that look lost or confused, anything that requires any assistance that we can provide.
The volunteers are also on hand to help passengers who have delayed, cancelled or missed flights.
Is your plane delayed?
Okay.
Where are you flying to?
I'm flying to Stockholm.
To Stockholm?
To fly to Greece now.
Oh, wow. Yes. The flight to Stockholm has been delayed for whatever reason. They were supposed to leave early this morning. Between the wee hours, I presume, is between 1 or 2 a.m. Has the representative of the airline spoken to you already?
No, we got some text messages.
Okay. If I don't see you, have a very safe flight back. Take care.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Ever vigilant, the duo continue their patrol. But raised voices at check-in have caught Ian and Cathy's attention, so they head over to investigate.
Is there a problem? Can I help you?
There's a really big problem. They're completely misunderstanding what we asked for, and now they're telling us she can't get on the flight.
Okay, so explain to me what the issue is.
She was diagnosed with iron deficient anemia, which can cause tiredness and fatigue.
Very frustrated, yeah. I mean, I asked them for just like a little bit of help. I wanted just a wheelchair in case I was feeling dizzy, and they just like misunderstood, thought that I was asking for medical assistance, took our passports, took our boarding passes, so that we couldn't even say like, oh, never mind, we don't need help. And now we're completely derailed, so.
And now they're telling her that they think there's some risk of her flying, which is completely untrue. It's medically not possible.
Unfortunately, what she had stated on her declaration form when she had booked the ticket, she had mentioned that she was anemic, and the airline took this as there was a problem with her anemia. Because she requires a wheelchair, that they've requested assistance, medical assistance.
This is the doctor, the company doctor.
And your doctor is wrong.
But hold on
your
a second, hold on a second.
Right now, call to check with the hospital.
We don't need to go to the hospital. She does not need to go to the hospital. Okay. We've been in this country for over 2 weeks.
I'll tell you what. I need you guys to calm down. Let me have a chat with these people. And then see if we can get... I know you're a little bit upset. Yeah.
We're not getting on our original flight. We're not getting back to New York when we're supposed to be getting back. We're on our honeymoon, so...
They're doing this to us.
This is how it's closing out. Yeah. But
angry, frustrated and stranded in a foreign country, it's now essential that Kate prove that she is actually well enough to board a flight. Time is ticking on whether they'll be flying at all. Coming up, Kate and Sam's problems go from bad to worse.
They are making us go to the hospital.
And we meet the Queen of Customs, Pui.
Sometimes you don't have to speak at all.
And it looks like everyone's got their eyes on the prize in the Phuket International Airport Toilet Awards.
The winner is going to get like $15,000.
Back with tourist police volunteers Ian and Cathy. They're attempting to calm a situation at departures.
Your doctor is wrong.
But hold on a second. Hold on a second.
Kate and Sam have been stopped at check-in until they're able to prove that Kate is well enough to fly. As an anemia sufferer, the airline are worried that she'd fall sick on the flight home to New York after she requested a wheelchair from airline staff. Ian has been speaking to the airline to try and sort things out.
From the manager, unfortunately, the airline has the policy if they're going to deny you based on health reasons that they want to do a fit-to-fly certificate, that I cannot force them not to do. But what I am going to make them do is make sure that they've got a ticket for you to go home on.
It was such a colossal misunderstanding, and like the fact that they've taken it this far is so frustrating.
Whenever you put a medical condition down, they're worried about if something happens on the flight. And I can understand it's an increase and decrease in pressure and cabin pressure. So if your hemoglobin count is low, it might actually cause for you to have a hematoma.
I just never thought it would have snowballed into not being able to get on a flight.
So we'll see. I'm going to try and make sure that they at least, if they take you down for a fit to fly certificate, that at least they got you booked on another flight home.
The airline have been able to push the couple's departure back to the next New York-bound flight, giving them a small window of wiggle room to get the medical sign-off needed. The check-in staff have the idea to head to the airport's medical center, but Ian isn't convinced.
Yeah, but I don't think they can do a blood test, and they have to pay here, right? We want you to do it here at the airport, at the local clinic, but unfortunately the airport's clinic does not have a blood work facility. We have to go to Tulang. They
can
do it here.
We can do the V25 ever, but cannot check the blood test. We recommend go to the hospital. Tulang hospital.
Right this minute, they are making us go to the hospital so she can get a blood test.
Yeah, even though the doctor's already cleared me to fly.
Yeah.
So, the hospital you go.
Left luggage.
So with their bags and left luggage, the pair now need to take a 60-minute round trip to have bloods taken before their flight leaves at 4 p.m., which is now in just under 2 hours' time. With the couple finally on their way to the hospital, things are finally falling into place. But unbeknownst to them, there's more bad news on the way. Tourist police volunteers Ian and Cathy are working to resolve an issue with two newlyweds. Due to questions surrounding her anemia, Kate and Sam need to get a fit-to-fly certificate to be allowed to even check in. The pair are now on their way to a local hospital for Kate's blood tests and to get the all-clear to fly.
Oh, the passengers... Hold on, the passenger is now already on their way to Tulang Hospital. They're already going. Yes. They're on the taxi. They're on their way there now. I cannot call the taxi to come back. The airline has just called me now, said that they've called ahead to Tulang Hospital for our American travelers to go do their blood test. And Tulang has informed them that they can do the blood test, but they won't get the results until Monday, so which means they won't get a fit to fly certificate until Monday because they don't do the blood work on weekends.
With it being a Saturday, most blood testing labs are not open, so the pair are unable to get the results of the tests, which is a huge blow for everyone.
So they have to wait till Monday. No, tomorrow Sunday, cannot get blood results tomorrow also. They are going to be extremely, extremely upset, first of all. I'm going to have to find a way to deal with that. Second of all, I need the airline to tell me what the status of their ticket's going to be. So can you find out what the story is with their tickets so that so at least I have information to give to them when they come back later. Okay, thank you. All right. So now we're going to have to find them a place to stay for the weekend at a hotel. This is not going to go down well. But, let's see what we can do.
Unaware that the hospital's blood testing centre is closed, Kate and Sam's luck seems to have finally run out. It looks like the pair's honeymoon is going to be remembered for all the wrong reasons. Back with tourist police volunteer Ian, he's helping an anemic honeymooner whose day has gone from bad to worse. Concerned for her health, the airline have requested a fit-to-fly certificate from a doctor before they can check in. Having sent the couple off to a hospital in a taxi, it seems Ian's master plan was slightly flawed.
The problem was is because it was a weekend, most hospitals do not do any blood tests on weekends. So after some phoning around, we found a private hospital in Phuket that was willing to do the checkup and do the physical and then determine if a blood test was necessary. With the results is we drove her down to the private hospital there, and the doctor did the physical, checked her vital signs, checked everything else, and declared that no blood test was necessary, that she would issue a fit-to-fly certificate straight away.
Even cleared to fly, the pair still have a 10-mile drive back and a mad dash through the airport to have a chance of making their 4 p.m. flight.
We phoned ahead and the airline said they will keep the counter open, especially for them. And we rushed back to the airport now to get them checked in.
I mean, we're really happy that you're here to help. I think we would have gotten a lot more frustrated.
Yeah.
You might have maybe gotten arrested.
They've now checked in. and they're currently now waiting to board their flight back to New York. Basically, the connecting flight that they're going to have is the same connecting flight that they were originally booked on. So the outcome is they're going to get home on schedule as it was planned.
Guaranteeing passenger safety is paramount to the airport, and with the help of Ian and the airline, our honeymooners left relieved and with smiles on their faces.
They're very grateful for the help that the tourist police has given him, and they're very grateful for the airline for accommodating him.
And with that problem solved, it's time to crack on with their patrol.